1, 2, 3, action!
It was the text before the first date.
Correct.
What was the text? What did you say?
You were at an event, and I told you we were talking about the event that you were at, and then we talked about church.
Fearless and Free Women's Conference.
Right.
Shout out. WOCC.
So you told me about that, and you know, I was intrigued, but we were texting, I think, while you were at the event, and you know, you invited me to come to the church, and that's when I put it out there that, hey, I can go there and sneak a peek at my friend. And you were like, who's that? I was like, you know, it's this petite lady, you know, kind of fly, you know, I think I'm feeling her. And then there was a long pause. It was silence.
Ultimately, that led up to the first date. We planned this event or this date. Really, he did. I didn't know what we were doing. And it was just amazing because he prepped it with the spa treat, which didn't expect that either. Well, when I got to our first location of our date, it was something that I always wanted to do. And he allowed me to check something off my bucket list. And we went to the
shooting range.
Yes! I thought I was like Charlie's Angel. So it was super sweet.
Well, I would say early on, I just kind of felt that there was something about Koren. I just couldn't put my finger on it. It was, you know, it's like she was more than just a breath of fresh air. She was just this genuine person who had this sweetness about her, this sincerity that I hadn't seen before. And it's something that spoke to me. And even as much as I fought it by saying, oh, it's too early. There's no way that I know this early. You know, something's going to happen. You know, let's wait for the other shoe to drop. But ultimately, I just knew early on that, you know, she was definitely one for me.
What is really great, though, real estate brought us together. I found this guy through the real estate industry. Thank you. I love my real estate career.
Right.
However, we've been even more fortunate because we've been also been able to be not just business partners, but life partners.
Correct. Yeah, it's just been great. I mean, just being able to work together, doing what we love, helping people purchase homes and I finance them, of course, but it's been great working together as a team. I wouldn't necessarily say conflict. There are certain times when we don't know how to turn it off, you know, and we're home. So, you know, that's the only downfall. Sometimes we just don't know when to turn it off.
I don't know. I think you did.
You may be right. I don't know. I really hadn't been keeping score. I just know that she was the one and she just lit up my life. So I'm glad that she's agreed to be mine.
Well, that was a unique situation. If anybody know my kids, we absolutely love each other, but they are super duper protective of their mom, especially my little man, AJ.
Especially AJ.
And so I knew that he was a great guy, but I had to do it right. And I just had to really pray on it and take my time with it. To be quite honest, it was like once they connected, it felt like they've known each other forever. And so we really, I think, at least I know I did, I've lost perception of time with our relationship, with time, with us as come together as one unit. I just feel like
it's meant to be.
Yeah, pretty much.
Today we celebrate the entrance of you two in the marriage covenant. We want to say to you that we see Jesus and his bride, the church, in your relationship. We see Jesus and the church in your determination to be one. As Jesus and the church are one in spirit and will and purpose, you two will be one. One faith, one family, one flesh.
When I wake up in the morning, love, sunlight hurts my eyes. And something without warning, love, bears heavy on my mind. Then I look at you, and the world's all right with me. Just one look at you, and I know it's gonna be a lovely day.
Both of you are responsible under God to make this marriage work, submitting to each other and to God. The Lord has not put the two of you together to compete with each other, but to work together in agreement. The marriage covenant presupposes that both the man and the woman have mutually agreed to come together. Coming together is far more difficult and complex than staying together.
Koren, woman of God, mother of our children, and my good thing. I vow to love you, cherish you, and respect you as the virtuous woman that you are. I'm overjoyed that God outdid himself when he made you. But as he's joining us on today, I promise that you will always be first in my life as I follow God. I commit my never-ending love and devotion to you, to our marriage, and to our kids. I love you.
Two years ago, you couldn't tell me that I'd be standing in front of you. My life has definitely been a journey, yet thankful for the opportunity that God has given me to love again and to find the most amazing partner that I can ever even pray for. When I look at you, I see more than a partner, more than just my best friend, more than my husband. I see a masterpiece of God's work and a love story that has limitless chapters. I promise I will support you in every endeavor. Promise I will support you and be faithful in every way. I will uplift and encourage you. I will laugh even when your jokes may not be funny.
Jokes always funny.
And moreover, I will always love you unconditionally and unselfishly. I thank you for being the man you are and finding me. You are truly an amazing gift from God. I love you, Marcus Dion.
For as much as Marcus and Koren have consented in holy wedlock and have witnessed the same by the joining of hands, by the taking of solemn vows, and by the exchanging of rings, in the presence of God's sight, before this company, as a minister of the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ, I pronounce they are husband and wife together. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, those whom God has joined together, let not man put asunder. My brother. I present to you the new Mr. and Mrs. Marcus and Koren Bowman.
And that time I went and said goodbye. first met you, you know, he instantly knew you were gonna be his wife. Instantly. He used to come home to manipulate this girl. And she's awesome, man. This is love I'm looking for. I'm like, okay, yeah, okay. A couple days later, you know, man, this could be Miss Bowman, man. This was like within a month after meeting you. And it's crazy. It's good though, man. But you changed him. I see how he changed. His grind got better. He wanted more hustle, boy. I mean, he watched you and you're like, man, this woman, I want this woman. And he was like, I gotta keep up with her somehow, some way. I gotta keep up with her.
I'm so thankful their paths are now one. I've learned from watching them that God will truly provide you with desires of your heart if you just trust him. No matter how scary things get. So today, we will honor them. Today we will celebrate their love. Today we will cry tears of joy. Today we will bless them and thank God for such a remarkable beginning.
And there's people in this world who don't know who God is or don't have a relationship with him. All they need to do is be in your presence one time or have one conversation with you to feel the Holy Spirit all over. I've seen you at your best, I've seen you at your worst, and you're still the baddest thing walking this earth. And so Marcus, thank you for coming into my sister's life at the perfect time and putting that pretty little smile on my sister's face. And most importantly, thank you for stepping up and being a father figure to my niece and nephew. And you heard AJ last night while in prayer. He thanked God that he finally had a father again. It really brought tears to my eyes, and not only did I gain a brother, but you gained an aggravating little sister that you would love for life.
Koren, we've been through thick and thin. We've been there for each other, the highs, the lows, and I'm grateful for it all. I mean, we should all have a friend like Koren. You know, the one that's gonna show up when you call her? Now, it may take her an hour, or two, or three, but she's gonna get back to you. It's like you called Leah yesterday. But she'll never let you down. She's that friend that would drive the Bronco for you. Well, maybe not the Bronco. Koren's a little too holy for that, but she'll call you Uber to get you out of a sticky situation. And I appreciate you for that. And she'll come over and preach to you and pray for you, and all will be well. Thank you. Much of the same, Marcus. What more could you ask for in a wife, a son, and a daughter? You're blessed. You're truly blessed. And Koren and the kids are blessed to have you as well. And I consider myself blessed to be a part of your family and this new journey.
I found love in you. And I've learned to love me too. Never have I felt that I could be all that you see. It's like our hearts have intertwined into the perfect harmony. This is why I love you. Ooh, this is why I love you. Because you love me. You love me. This is why I love you. Ooh, this is why I love you.